Good evening, everyone. We're back in the kitchen at my house, using the stove as an easel, stove and hood. And this is the third session of painting an abstract painting from scratch. Trying to figure out, well, what do you do when you face the canvas? Where's this abstraction come from? So we'll do a little review here. We originally started off by drawing a circle and a square on this canvas. And then we did two connecting lines, which sort of divided the canvas in half. Now the first night we painted this yellow in, and we painted a portion of the square in black here. Some of the turquoise we put these, these lines were in, the turquoise and the turquoise down in the corner in this rectangle. After we got off camera, painted in this abstract shape, and that was it. Our next video, we came back here, and we put a horizontal line in, this half circle, painted this in purple, and painted this in red. We also drew this shape in over here and painted this in red. And it was sort of like resembles a bow tie and a couple buttons over here, and we painted those in black. We got off camera and we painted this shape in, leaving a sort of a dove shape in here. So, like I said, you know, we work on these and we do a little bit and then we look at them, and that kind of leads us into what else we want to do, what other shapes we want to draw into the canvas. So that's what I've done since our last video. So I worked out this section down here on the bottom, and I put in this line over here. We've got some room for color in this area in here, and all down through here. I think predominantly this is going to stay white through here, and probably over here. So we're going to move on to painting this section down in here. And I decided that I would go with black in this area, and can you see that area okay in the camera? I think, well, let me lift it up a little bit. Let me see if I can adjust this camera, this, camera so that it shows that bottom corner a little better. Yeah, here we go. I think that will work. Okay, so we're going to paint this section in there in black and this section here in red. So why don't we, and I hope some of you have been working on canvases at home. You know, I mean, we've got a lot of time to kill. We're shut in here with this pandemic. And so it's a good time to drag out the paints and occupy some of that time. I'm working on, I'm working on some model airplanes and this canvas here, which should be, this canvas should be done by I think one more session, and we'll be all set with this here. And then, you know, after you get it to the point where you say it's done, then you take a couple days and look at it and see if there's any little last minute changes you want to make in it, a little more detail, but basically the painting should be together. It's like a 4 or 5 session painting, you know, and that's if you don't take too long trying to figure out where your next lines are going. Sometimes they come easy and sometimes not so easy. Now, this one here seems to be coming together pretty good anyway. And then, you know, after all the colors are on, then we'll kind of go back and put a second coat on colors that are still a little bit transparent, you know. Painting over a white canvas and dark colors usually takes at least 2 coats. I like painting with this 1-inch swept back brush. And you can get most of the corners. Sometimes things get real tight. You gotta resort to going to the 1-inch, the number 2 round. But most of the time, you see, that's a pretty sharp corner. Able to get in there okay. And you can paint right up to the line. Like I said in an earlier video, you know, I like to outline my abstracts in black. It's something, a habit I got into a long ago. It kind of separates the colors, and it's not for everyone, but I like it. So, now this is the cadmium red that I'm putting on. Oh, and the other night we hadn't decided what color the big circle should be. We were talking about it just before I got off camera, and then I finally did decide and went with the orange. And that's cadmium orange too. And it covers real good. But still, you know, most of these colors, depending, if you don't want any transparency, you're gonna have to go and put a second coat on. That's the 3 o'clock Christmas clock. So it is 3. It is 3 a.m. right now, and because we got our days and nights totally mixed up, we're painting in the middle of the night and sleeping in the day, and in a situation like the world is in right now, that's, everything's fair. We don't have any place we gotta go. And we're saving lives by staying home. And the main life we save might be our own. At least we're hoping to get through this. I have one friend that came down with it, but another friend who had friends up in New York, and they several of them came down with the illness, and but they've all recovered. They haven't lost anybody. Well, that's good. So we're almost done painting this patch of red in here, and we're gonna. As I said in an earlier video, I like to paint odd numbers. In other words, either use the color once, three times, five times. It's color balance. I mean, there's no rule or law. You're not gonna look it up in a book, but it seems to balance the color fine, and so it's a rule I use for as to how many times I'm gonna use a particular color in the painting. Okay, one more little spot over here, and then we're gonna move on. I got a little bit of cheap painting on the top here, but this paint's drying up on me. Okay. Now we got pretty good coverage on that for first coat. I'll let it go like that for now, and I'll come back some point later and just touch up any areas that don't look I got the right amount of color. So there we go. So let's see. So we got the three places that we've used red. Let's see, if I put it here, that'll be four. We're gonna do black in here. And sometimes it's hard to jump ahead, you know, you got the red paint out, so you say, well, you know, I mean, where else do I want red? Well, that doesn't always work out that way. So we're better off to just cap the red and do the next color that I know. And the next color I know is the, we're gonna put black in. So let me wash this brush out and in the sink here. And again, I'm gonna get do that section above the red in black. Now these, I mentioned it before, I paint with these, with acrylic paint that comes from Nova out of California. It's opaque, it covers very well. Prices are very good, you can buy it online, they'll send it to you. They'll send it to you by UPS or FedEx or whatever. And they get it to you in a few days. Then I buy these nice big quart tubs. Colors, reds and oranges are the most expensive, but the colors are reasonable. Okay, so back on camera here, we got this brush all wiped out. A little bit of paint over here on a white bump. I can still get it up. Okay. There we go. All right. Hey, Blackie. That's my little cat, Blackie. And she's, you want to come and say something, Blackie? Huh? Right, she's 18 years old. And, requires a lot of attention. She's a very, very loud voice when she wants it. Okay, so like we said, we're gonna paint this section in here in black. And keep going fairly quick. Your lady's out in black is with an acrylic pen, and it makes it easy. You can just paint to the line. I'm developing your own paint by numbers. So we got that section painted in the black. A little touch up here, I'll get that while I got the black out, but yeah. And up here. Now, a lot of people are watching and rewatching programs like on, well, Netflix, on HBO. We've been watching Game of Thrones. Probably going to take another look at Breaking Bad. We're planning our next marathon. Okay. All right, just did a couple touch-ups there. We're going to do another section of black right here. Let's see if that drop that down just a little bit, like that. Yeah, you can see it better that way, sure. Okay. Now, as I said, I like to paint them out to the edge, so I paint over the edge, like in the yellow, and then I bring my black line out, and that gives me a little better than average, better than looking at the edge of a canvas, a little more interesting. And it's all, you know, really in, up to the individual and what they decide, how they want to paint. Black is going in real good and real fast. And there we go. Okay, so now the next thing is to figure out what's next. I thought about bringing this turquoise up into this section here, which I added to this painting after one of our sessions. And now I'm trying to figure out what's going to go in here. This could be a turquoise, and this could be an additional red, and that would bring our reds up to our turquoise up to 4, which would be an even number, and our reds up to 4 as well. But we have an area in here, we can add a color, and actually this would be a fourth turquoise right here. We do have a dividing line there. We're going to leave this white. Pretty sure we're going to leave this white. I think something's going to happen in here, and then the majority of this will stay white, but I think we're going to have some kind of a division in here. So we'll look at that and our time off and try to determine what that's going to be. So rather than, let's see. Rather than just jump in here, because I'm uncertain about what colors I want to use there, and I don't want to be painting it, because once the color's in, that's it. I think we're going to bring the turquoise up into here. And then we'll take a look and see what we got next. Let me wash out this brush. And wash up this tub of paint. So you see it's coming together. But, little by little. I really don't have a lot of time on this plan, really. Maybe 3 hours, something like that. We probably got another 3 hours looking at it, trying to decide what you want to do next on it after you finish one little session of painting. Okay. Alright, so we got that brush washed down. I want to go get a tub of blue paint, which is in the other room, and I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back with you. Let's see what we got here. Okay, so we're gonna paint this area in here turquoise. And we're coming down into another area that's already turquoise, and we're going to just make it one area all the way up. Corner up in here. I'm painting the line. Well, you can do these lines in pencil. I mean, not everybody's going to want to outline all their geometrics in black like I do, but you can do them in pencil. Sometimes pencil, if you paint over it, depending on the color of paint, can add a little bit of a different tint to the paint, almost produces another color, or has a blending effect, or shading effect. This is definitely going to take 2 coats because we'll let that set up a little bit. I got to get just this corner up on top here. Okay. So we got a first coat on that. And you gotta set up a little bit, and then I come over while we got this paint out, and give another coat on a turquoise or blue, turquoise blue that we already have, that we painted it earlier. The covers were real nice on the second coat. And you can cut the wrong line just like that. And tap it on the top of my head here now. I'll make a little adjustment in our camera. Okay, got another coat over that. This is pretty solid in here. I think we coated that over again once already. Put a little bit on that line there. See what we're doing over here now. Is it, Let me get another coat on there. Let me take three. But the coat underneath is not totally dry, so you brush it and it activates the paint again, you know. Like that. Probably better give it some more time. I'll let that blue over there dry some more. So that's actually three. That's become one coat, so that's three turquoise, and maybe enough turquoise for this painting. And maybe we're going to have some different colors for over in here. Okay, so I'm going to flip this over or up on this edge for a minute. And I hope you can see this in the camera. I'm going to paint that bottom because remember we carry our paint out to the edge, and so because it's sitting down on that edge, we didn't do it. So we'll put a coat of paint on that now. And you get a chance to look at your abstract painting, and you know, maybe you like it better like this. I mean, I always can flip them around and see if you see something different that you like better. That's fair. Some of the best mistakes, some of the best things happen by accident. All right, and a little paint over there. Closer to the line. You get close to the line like that, you can always, you know, wipe it off with your finger. That works. So let's go outside the line. So, let's see. Where we at? I'm going to put a coat of red down here. Carry that line up just a little higher. So, well, now we got it laying over on it, so and a chance to paint the edges in, because this blue is not going to be dry enough to actually, well, maybe it's getting better. Yeah, it's drying up. And we're hoping to open the gallery back up. Well, we were hoping originally to open it back up by the end of the month, but we're kind of looking at what's going on and how many people are coming down with the virus, and it's not looking like that was a reasonable estimate of when we should open back up. I hear there's some places trying to rush it. Up in Jacksonville, they're talking about opening up parks next week or something. That's what I heard. And I just think that's the real dangerous stuff. Gambling with people's lives. It's pretty hard to social distance in a park. We'll see. Okay, so I'm gonna do a little bit of block that in red, and I think I'm gonna wait till our next probably do some black here, and our next session I will have figured out what colors I'm gonna put in these two spaces, and I think we're gonna have another shape in here. I'm also gonna figure out what colors I'm gonna put alongside the black here. And we'll go from there. That will get pretty close to finishing it at that point. And then, like I said before, it's just a little touch-up that you might want to do. Okay, so let me wash this brush out. And, you could probably, looks like it probably could go in a couple different directions. It's not too bad in the direction I have it in right now, which is basically 90 degrees from what I thought was going to be the top of the painting, but could very well go that way. If I did this all the time, I probably would do a little more brushes, so I wouldn't have to wait while I'm washing out a brush. But this is something I'm just doing while we're shut in. I don't paint on a regular basis. I have painted a few canvases lately. One of my students wanted to paint, so he got me into painting. And painted a 3-4 canvas. This is a lot of fun after you're getting back into it. Let's see, we're gonna do that red. We'll coat up a couple pieces of red that we got here. We're gonna cut that black in the bottom, and I think that'll do it for us for tonight. So let's see. The red's gonna come in from the side. Gonna come right up and match almost with that turquoise. Now there'll be a black line between them. So you see where that's going there? I don't know if you can see that. You see that where I'm painting now? Right on the edge. I gotta get over here. There's Blackie in the background there. The plant cats are getting plenty of company with us home all the time. We got three cats here in the house, and we got about 10 out the back door there. We got little cat houses that are like dog houses out there, and they're feral, but they're not too feral. We've been feeding them for a long time. We feed them 3-4 times a day with dry food, and once a day we give them canned food in the afternoon. And they really like that canned stuff. Anyways, we got stocked up pretty good over here, so we won't be running out of it. It wasn't like that, I can tell you. The second coat really covers good. And this red's just dry enough now to. This is the second color that we put on tonight, and it's plenty dry enough to. Take the second coat. See, got a couple spots that we painted in over here. Got a mosquito in the kitchen here. Raccoon knocking on my back door.
like that cap, but. Okay, let's see, one more spot of red here. And we're gonna do that little bit of black on the edge and I'm gonna call it a night. For painting anyway. Alright, so we've got a second coat on all that red, and I'm going to put a coat of black over here on this edge. Let me slide this over a little bit so you can see what's going on over here. Do that black. We'll wash this brush out. And this would be the last color going on tonight. And then you get to think about what else happens on this. Maybe the final page of this painting, but it may be two more settings. Let's see. Okay. Hey, Blackie again. Hey, Blackie, you want to come and say hello to everybody? Come on. Come on. Come on, Blackie. Come on. Come on. Come on. There she is. He's Blackie. Yeah, but it's our 18-year-old beauty. Yeah, she's a sweetie. I'm Blackie. Okay, go ahead. Go ahead. Go ahead. Alright. A little bit of black, and that's it for tonight. And that's going to go right in this area right here. See, painting that in. You see what's happening with the color running up, and then we'll put the black line out to the edge too.
go. Well, so we got a lot of white left on this painting, so I'm going to try to figure out between now and our next session. I'm pretty well figured that these two areas are going to be a different color. We're going to put some color in through this section here. This may very well stay white, and this may stay white. That white may carry on. Yeah, I think there's going to be another shape in here to eat up some of that white and put a different color in there, and that's going to do it. So, from my house to yours, that's it for tonight. It is 3:50 a.m. I hope everybody stays healthy and safe, and we'll see you next time. Bye.